We're getting word, I kid you not, this is from our colleagues at the New York Post, that NBA star turned Kim Jong-un's soulmate, as they call him, Dennis Rodman, will be in Singapore ahead of the president's summit with the North Korean dictator. In fact, he might be part of this ongoing process. When I think of who could figure out what the heck this means, I go to my buddy, my good friend for so many years, Charles Payne, to put him on the spot in his career as well. What the heck? What does that mean?
Well, it means Peter Navarro's out or Wilbur Ross now.
Exactly. Dennis Rodman is down.
Now we know we got a deal. It sounds like some sort of publicity. We better wait to get more information on that. But it certainly sounds like someone having a good time. I mean, it's good. He's going to get a lot of publicity. So maybe if he's wearing a pair of Skechers or something like that.
And you know, one of the few Americans who had a relationship, and it was an ongoing one with Kim Jong-un. And I'm just wondering, the president probably can use all the friends he can get for this big meeting. But a week from today, the pressure's on. The timetable is on. It's one day, and that's it.
Kim Jong-un went to school in the West. He obviously admired, Western culture, including basketball. And a lot of people say that the Olympics, you know, going into watching what's happening, that maybe, just maybe, he does want something for his people. And I think the administration must believe that, too, because President Trump over and over again has made these overtures about hardworking North Koreans, about the opportunities and about the investments that are going to pour in from China, Japan, South Korea. He has made this overture very, very many times. So maybe someone in the White House believes also that's another strong negotiating point.
What you said is very deep and profound. What you're missing is that maybe he just wants a fast food outlet. Right? Because that was one of the things that we were sort of dangling.
Well,
right?
Guess what? You can get a Mickey D's. You can get a KFC. You can get it all. You know what? Get you a Starbucks. We could throw it all in there. This is like Ron Papelli. But wait, there's more.
You know, the onus does seem to be on us, though, to provide a lot of money. Now, the president's already made clear and lowered expectations. I mean, that don't expect a lot of that, and don't expect us to sort of be the sugar daddy here. But I am wondering what we would offer in return for kingdom to start denuclearizing.
I've asked that question of all the experts, and none have given me an answer. But there's no doubt. The nukes are North Korea's, they're the only currency they have. They make a few bucks making those big bronze statues for other dictators. But besides that, it's the only currency that they have. To give that up, you need a combination of guaranteed safety and major economic injections. And so it's going to be a big number, I think. But yeah. I think the world will say the number can't be too big if you can get rid of this most dangerous part of the planet.
You know, separately, we got signs that it was lost in the army today that the Chinese are offering to buy up to $70 billion worth of agricultural goods from us. Not much reaction. Maybe some people didn't take it seriously. But that would be quite a coup for the president were it to pass.
I think a lot of other presidents would have taken that, ran with it, spiked the ball, and declared victory. President Trump is playing a very, very tough game here. It's a strong, strong, tough
game. So he didn't respond one way or the other, right?
I think it's a good overture, and I think it's, he threw out some larger numbers than that, but $70 billion is huge. Maybe they'll work on the technology side. I think ultimately we're going to hear some sort of number of $100 billion talked about. It'll probably be a combination of lower tariffs and the ability to open up their markets, but also you've got to get something on the technology side, particularly since President Trump revived ZTE.
All right. Charles, thank you very much. You were ready for that Rodman thing. Unfortunately, I thought I'd kind of zing you with that one.